Welcome back to another Pokemon What If Wednesday, where every single Wednesday morning I post a video going through last week's investing and collecting questions, where your guys' questions will actually be featured in the video itself. So please drop your questions down below for a chance to be featured in next week's video. And if I did comment to you saying great question, I might use this and I didn't, please drop that same question again and I will move that to the top. I can only do so many per video. And I'm not saying I'm some guru who just knows everything, but when I'm unsure, I always like to talk it out with a few people. It always helps me make my final decision. And we do got to give thanks to our video sponsor today. This is a brand new sponsor and a brand new app. So please go show them some love and show them what the Pokebeard fans can do. The app is completely free and there are zero ads. It is called Shiny. You can find it in your Play Store. Just got to type in Shiny TCG or use the links in the description. If you guys are interested in keeping track of your current collection, this is the perfect app for you. Yes, there are other apps that can do this, but these guys really pride themselves in having the most up-to-date and honestly the most cards and boxes, especially when it comes to Japanese Pokemon. They got Magic the Gathering, they got Lorcana, and it's so easy to just search up a card or a box and add it to your current collection. I am currently doing that right now with my collection. I just added a few of my more higher priced items. You know, I got my first edition PSA 10 Lugia, I got a bunch of Sky Ridge booster packs, and then I got quite a few Unified Minds booster boxes. And then I'm gonna this week at all my cards and all my boxes, and we'll see how high I can get. So definitely check it out. The links are in the description. But all right, let's get to it. First question is from at Wreck-It Roush. What are your thoughts on the Surging Sparks Pokemon Center ETB and promo? I know booster boxes are considered the gold standard of Pokemon investing, but I feel like a couple of these Pokemon Center exclusive ETBs may give the booster boxes a run for their money in the future. Pikachu on the box can't hurt. I fully agree. We've never had ETBs like this before. We've never had promos like this before. I really, really do think they're going to do super, super good. Usually the booster boxes is always king, but you never know with some of these special promos. I ordered a case of the Surging Sparks ETBs, the Pokemon Center ones, of course. Definitely a big fan. So yeah, I agree. I wouldn't maybe go crazy on every single set, but still, this is a beautiful ETB. I mean, that Pikachu is gorgeous on it. The purple's nice. It's a very, very solid box. And the promos, very solid. The same artist that did the Giratina and the Magikarp. Next question is from at CoffeeAddict77. Best new release investment for 100 or 150 a month in your opinion. Terrapagos UPC, Stellar Crown Pokemon Center ETB, Surging Sparks Pokemon Center ETB, or combination thereof. Keep up all the great content. I'm definitely going to go Surging Sparks. Next is from at BrendanFribley148. What are your thoughts on the Japanese Versus set? I love the Japanese Versus set. It's one of my all-time favorite sets. Pretty much every one of these cards was not printed in English. I guess there's a couple that were, but technically they were for like a deck for like 24 people or something like that at some tournament. They made them for English, but 99% of these cards are not in English, and the arts are insane. But I am currently collecting this set. I'd say I'm maybe halfway done. Maybe. But the ones that I have right now are in super, super good condition. So I'm very, very happy with that. But every art is insane. Like every single art. But all right, next is from at NTS Brids. Repeat question. What do you think about investing into the vending series? Been thinking about it. Well, I also collect these guys also. Again, super awesome arts. Like you really cannot beat these arts. So unique and weird and I mean, look at that Mewtwo. Just crazy. But I love collecting like the Japanese cards that we didn't get in English. You know, I mostly collect English, but I have a pretty solid Japanese binder. And they're basically all cards that we never got in English. So that's what I collect for Japanese. But all right, next question is from at Adam Mason. How do you actually store your collection that isn't on display? Home Depot crates? Any tricks, tips you found? Well, now that I got this sponsor here, I love getting like the 20 pack here for 40 bucks. And then, you know, I do have the promo code Pokebeard for 15% off. But I am for sure boxing up everything right now. Especially, it's so cheap too when you're getting it in bulk like this, these cases. I have ruined so many booster boxes and ETBs. But now I just literally use these things and I just put them in super nice totes. I do have a storage unit too. So a lot of my stuff is there. But that's because we have like a ton of stuff though. So I have a lot of collectibles. But yeah, I love these cases. Now I get them for booster boxes and ETBs. They were not a sponsor of this video. When we're talking, you know, $2 a case, basically, a little less with the promo code to protect your boxes, it's a no-brainer. That's why I strongly suggest not going crazy on, like, the actual collection boxes. Man, the amount of damaged collection boxes that I have is wild. Everyone's just a little bend here and there. So yeah, I'm just trying to case up everything, and then you can just store it in honestly whatever you want, as long as it's not like super, super humid and stuff like that. That's all I worry about. Next is from at Joe Millerniv 66. How would you judge the value of cards like Team Magma's Groudon EX? eBay sales are wildly all over with pricing conditions. I love the art and want one and the Kyogre, but don't know how much is too much to spend. Well, that really depends on you and how picky you want to be on condition. So if you check the eBay recently sold listings, you just got to sit and click on all the ones until you find like the condition that you would be happy with. And then that's going to be your base price. And then just keep looking at more and more and more, seeing what's available. Then I also like to check like the graded cards. So you can definitely crack slabs. You know, a 7.5 CGC isn't terrible. You know, maybe that'd be good enough for you. That sold for $71. Crack that slab, throw it in the binder. Let's try to find a little bit higher grade here. We got a PSA 1 for 100, but people kind of have a premium on ones. So we got a PSA 9 for 345, another 9 for 371, and we got a PSA 7 for 159 or best offer, and one for 125. But in my opinion, it's probably going to cost you around $100 probably to get a nice, nice raw copy. But again, you know, maybe that CGC 7.5 for $70 isn't a terrible idea. It really just depends on how picky you are. But yeah, that's all you can really do is check the last sold listings and just find the condition that you'd be happy with and kind of go off that. Next question is from at one lucky viewer. If you had 36 loose packs of Team Up, would you open them, keep them sealed, or use as trade? I definitely would not open them. Let's take a little peek here. Team Up packs last sold. So we got two at 55, 50, 51, 55. Honestly, I would keep them. The only thing I would maybe trade them for is like other booster boxes. But again, Team Up is very, very special. Very special. I could see these packs being $100, $150, $200. So in my opinion, if it were me, I would keep them. But a trade is definitely possible. I wouldn't trade for cards because cards were probably not going to do as good as sealed products. But yeah, Team Up is a crazy set. Next is from a member at Kyle of White 8812. Repeat question. What are your thoughts on the 2024 World Championship Pikachu with the Mew promo? Was available on the UK Pokemon Center until December and has already sold out. I picked up a couple and I'm going to grade them for a personal collection, but wanted your view. Thanks again for the content. My favorite video of the week. I really, really appreciate that. Let's check out the Pikachu. Recently sold. So we got $450 at the best offer with $4 in shipping. And that is sealed. Let's see. $46 for four of them. But that's from the UK. Here we go. We got four of them for about $35. We got one for about $8-$9. We got a PSA 9 for $66. I do like the card. I do wish the promos would be a little bit better, you know, start giving us some illustration rares and stuff like that. But I love the Mew and the Pikachu battling. Not sure if it's going to be super, super crazy expensive in the future. It was pretty easy to get. Best Buy had them also. I think GameStop had them. Like, a lot of places had them. So when they do it like that, where you can get them kind of everywhere, they're usually never super, super expensive. But I mean, even seeing the PSA 9 for $66 sold on August 26, that's a good amount of value for technically getting the card for free for just getting a few other things. And I looked, I didn't really find any 10s for sale, so might be kind of tough to get. Maybe you should check the pop report. But yeah, when you're talking free cards like that, you can't really go wrong, especially when it's Pikachu. But I don't think it'll be super, super crazy. Next is from at Eric Vander Ploeg 9969. Hi, Pokebeard. Really like the transparency and information you provide on the channel. Question is it a good time to purchase the cards 203 TM 208 PSA 10 from Temporal Forces? It's for collection only, so I'd like to know what you think. Much love from the UK. So I'm guessing you're talking about the Raging Bolt card in a PSA 10. Last sold 191, 190, 189, 170, 162. Well, that got pretty cheap just in a little bit. So if you are going to get it, definitely try to get it towards that 160 mark, which looks possible. A good amount of Scarlet and Violet cards will come down in price once we start getting these newer super crazy sets. But you never know, 151's popping off right now. But if you can get it for maybe 150, 160, I feel like that's not going to be too bad. You probably wouldn't lose too much money if it did come down. It is probably my favorite special illustration rare for that entire set. Next is from @treadlightly270. Hey, Pokebeer, started watching you a few months ago and I love all the content. Question, I have a master set, including reverses of Evolving Skies, the pre-release bundle stamp promos, all the promos that came in the 3-pack blisters, and all the evolutions from the premium boxes that came out around the same time. Wondering what you think the max potential is value-wise for this. Just been sitting on it. Maybe in the future would like to use it toward a newer vehicle. So let's take a little peek. Last sold 100% mint complete master set with stamp promos, sold for $2,900. Then we got $3,000 there. We got 1,596% complete. So we'll just go off these last two, and they're pretty recent. Yeah, I could definitely see this set getting up to $5,000 pretty easily. And I don't think it would take that long either. You know, I wonder what the sales were during the last alt art boom that we had, but I'm not sure. Let's actually check highest first. Let's see, we got the PSA 10 evolutions. Here we got the Evolving Skies complete 369 card master set, sold for $4,200. And that was during June. So yeah, that was probably a little more towards the alt art boom that we just had this summer. But yeah, I think I would definitely hold on to it a bit longer for sure. Wait for the next crazy boom for Evolving Skies. Super cool set though. Congratulations on completing that. Super good question though. Next is from @wargasm509. I have the entire 151 illustration rare and above in PSA 10 slabs. Should I sell and move money around for different slabs? If so, which ones, or should I hold? Also, I might hold on for a personal collection. Thank you in advance. Then he also says all the 151 slabs and the UPC promos are worth $3,233 as of 8/26/24. Well, technically 151 is popping off really hard right now. So I would definitely wait a little bit and see how crazy it can get. And in my opinion, I have a feeling these 151 cards are going to be pretty expensive in the future, especially if we don't get like a massive reprint or if we don't get a ton of reprints. I really feel like these cards are going to be pretty expensive. So if it were me, I would definitely hold on to them. You know, hopefully you got them for good deals and stuff like that. Especially if, you know, maybe we're buying them raw and then getting them graded yourself. But to be honest, they've been pretty undervalued this whole time. So even if you did go buy them all in PSA 10s, you really didn't overpay that much, in my opinion. So congratulations on completing that also. Next is from @AlexAnderlund8349. I keep butchering all these names. Repeat question, what do you think of the Kamili Super Smash Bros. Cards? They have the possibility of pulling Pokemon cards out of 255 that have a great cracked ice holo. I think they would be great to pick up since they are not only beautiful but limited. So I actually didn't know anything about these guys really. So I just, you know, did a little bit of research. And honestly, they're pretty cool. Some of these Pokemon cards are pretty crazy. Again, don't know if they're going to be grails, but it really depends because you got to think of how many people know about them. That's the thing. If a ton of people don't know about them, they're never going to be worth that much money. But there's some cool ones for sure. Like zoom in here. They got like the Pikachu and stuff like that. They look pretty nice. I have not seen these in person actually. Pretty curious. But I mean, we got the limited edition Pikachu here for $300 or best offer. Here we got kind of the cracked ice Pikachu here for $30. Looks pretty cool. Again, though, I collect anything Pokemon, so if I seen these in person, I'd probably pick them up. Especially if they are limited and they're not super, super expensive. It might be worth it. You never know. Next is from @JohnMcCrary6701. Not an investment question, but an interesting one. What card do you own the most copies of and why? Also, really love the videos. Keep it up. Appreciate that. That would be Dragonair from base set. It's my number one all-time favorite card. I want to say I have maybe like 20 of them for unlimited base set. And then I want to say I have maybe like 10 of them in Shadowless. And then I want to say I have maybe like another 10 of them in first edition Shadowless. And then I probably have another 10 that are like in different languages even. Every time I see one in good condition, I buy it. Like, look at that background. Look at that. Someone needs to turn this card into an actual illustration rare for me. I know some people can do that with like fake cards. I would love that. I have not seen that yet, but I think that is one of the best backgrounds. Not one of the best. It is the best background in all of base set. Next is from at MPJiggy. Thanks so much for answering my question. Truly appreciate it. Got another one. I've been looking at some of my favorite first edition Pokemon in a PSA 6, 7. Some of them are pretty nice and great prices too. PSA 10 first edition is just way too out of my budget. I feel you there. Was wondering your opinion on picking up first editions in PSA 6, 7, and 8. Well, I can show you. I just got this Smeargle here in a PSA 7. Didn't even need this card. I already have this card. First edition, $55 or best offer. I shot him an offer of $40. He accepted it. Sweet. Not a bad deal at all. But yeah, I'm a big fan of buying cards like that. If I were you, I would try to stay away from sixes, try to stick with sevens and eights. But again, if it's a clean six, definitely you can buy it. You know, don't always just buy the grade. But yeah, if you find a good deal, not bad at all if you want that. It's a perfect binder card. I always feel like a PSA 7, 8, or 9 is just so good for the binder. But I feel you on PSA 10s being so expensive. That's why I would always rather have 10 copies of a bunch of cards that I need than one PSA 10 copy. The only time I ever really want a PSA 10 copy for myself is if it's one of my all-time favorite cards. Next is from at Feek of the Kid. I have some ETBs that have minor rips from when someone used a box cutter to open the case. Do you think these small rips significantly reduce the value of boxes? I'm considering selling or trading them, but if the rips are going to result in a major markdown, I might just hold onto them instead. Dots. Yeah, that's the one bad thing about, you know, investing in sealed Pokemon products. You will damage some boxes. So what I usually do, I honestly open my damaged boxes, but I also have a channel and trying to get all these cards and stuff too. But if you can trade them for something that isn't damaged, that's probably what I would do. Because even if you hold on to them and they do go up in value, when you go to sell them, it's going to be a pain. You know, you're going to have to discount them a ton. It honestly sucks. So yeah, I always just, you know, I just cracked open an ETB because it had a big hole in it. What was it? Paldea Evolved. I dropped a Paldea Evolved ETB, dented the bottom a little bit, and it cut it. I just instantly ripped it open right there, and we opened some packs. So, yeah, it does suck. Next is from at Matt Azarello. Hey, Beard, love the content and all the great advice. Just got back into the hobby. My four-year-old is loving Pokemon. I've started a little sealed booster box collection and some base set slabs. I've recently started to buy some modern singles, best conditions I can find. Is this a decent strategy for someone just getting into the hobby? Yeah, I think it's perfect. No joke. Perfect, especially if you're buying some nice PSA 9 cheap base set slabs that are completely undervalued right now. And then, yeah, if you're buying these singles raw in the best condition possible that could get 10s, that's super smart. All I would maybe add is a couple nice Pokemon Center ETBs of the better sets when you can. Otherwise, perfection. Next, kind of the same type of question is from at Big Goo Goo X. Hi, Pokebeard. Hope you're doing good. Doing great. I wanted to ask, what is your opinion on expanding my English sealed Pokemon Center exclusive ETB collection? I am buying two of each that contain a Pokemon Center promo, and I was wondering if you think that was a good investment long term. Like I said, love them. I do always try to get at least three of everything, so you just have more options. You know, you can hold one forever, you know, and then you can sell one 5 years down the road and then sell another one 20 years down the road. But yeah, love the Pokemon Center ETBs. Maybe try to get a couple booster boxes in there and you'll be doing great. Next, same type of question is from at Rick Geminez 4269. Brother, I have a question. I'm just starting buying Pokemon boxes. I'm buying booster boxes, two of each series. Is this good or not? You cannot go wrong buying booster boxes. Like I said before, I try to get three of everything. And then if you're doing it for each set, you might be better off like going after the more popular sets instead of every single set. But, you know, my OCD, I also want to get stuff for every single set. But it would be a little smarter to, you know, be a little bit more picky and maybe stock up on the better sets. Next is from at Andrew Dickinson 1702. Is the newest set worth a buy or is it a skip? I'm not sure if I'm feeling it. And he said Stellar Crown with the Sparks set coming out. I'm going to probably say skip, you know, save your money. If you do want to open a few things, just buy a few sleeve booster packs here and there, or get a Pokemon Center ETB so you get the promos. Take a chance at, you know, getting the chase card, and that's probably all I would do. Next is from at DylanLewis8450. Hello, Pokebeard. Solid content, man. My question is, just made a huge trade. My PSA 10 Burning Shadow Zard for a sealed Cosmic Eclipse ETB in team of booster box. What do you think of this good trade, especially in terms of future game potential? Perfect. You did great. I think you definitely came out on that one for sure. Honestly, perfection. Next is from at KaiWeng5682. I apologize if I butchered the name. I recently bought a whole album of uncut Burger King Pokemon Mewtwo return cards. Do I grade it as a whole uncut, or just pluck it out and grade the highest valued ones? It's tough for me. Whenever I get those sheets, I can never pluck them out. I don't know. It's so tough. Honestly, though, the Burger King ones, they don't move very often. It's sad to say, a lot of those cards do not. But I am not 100% sure on like the pop reports on some of those. I've gotten quite a few of those albums, and they weren't the best condition. Like, you could tell they weren't going to grade. So it really just depends on the condition. But super cool cards. I enjoy them. Next is from at Dark Rise Dungeon. Getting closer to 150K subs. Nice work, man. Keep grinding. Thank you. As for a question, I want to know if you watch any sports and what your teams are. And we also got another question from at Chasing Celebi, who's a member. I know you mentioned MMA, but are you a team sports fan? What sports teams do you follow, root for? And do you collect sports TCG? I feel like you have to put a ton more money into the sports hobby. I do. I collect basketball cards. That's probably all I collect for like sports cards. I do collect sports like memorabilia, like jerseys and signed basketballs and stuff like that. I have a bunch of signed baseballs and bats. But honestly, my true love is probably fighting. I used to watch a lot of golf too. I'm a big golfer. But yeah, I would definitely say I'd watch probably 90% UFC and then 10% the Minnesota Twins. I'm really, really trying to go to games in person. Every once in a while, I'll catch them on TV. But it's been so busy, it's tough to watch a whole baseball game at your house. But seriously, one of the best things, going to a night game, perfect weather. You really cannot beat that. That's mine and my wife's favorite thing to do. Next question is from another member, at AaronBF20. I appreciate you guys being members. It seriously means so much. Where do you typically sell cards? Have you done any live auctions such as Whatnot? Well, I've had multiple meetings with Whatnot and Drip. They both want to pay me to sell on their platform, but I'm not really going to do that right now. I honestly just sell on eBay, and then I just trade at card shows if I want to get rid of something. But yeah, I like selling on eBay because then it, you know, builds up my seller status and everything. Like, I got 21,000 cards sold on eBay. So yeah, I always like to build up that reputation, even if it's not the best spot, which I think eBay probably gets the most eyes. But with eBay fees, it's kind of annoying. Next is from at It's Ray J. What are your thoughts on collecting sealed versus slabs and singles? I want to do both, but financially, I don't think I can continue. Would you suggest going sealed or singles for long-term investment? If you're talking just pure investment-wise and you want to just make the most money possible, definitely do sealed. It's your best option, and still you're kind of collecting Pokemon too. You can just, like, you know, get one of each set or whatever you want to do, you know. You can still make it a fun collection even though it is just sealed products. But yeah, sealed is definitely the way to go. Next question is from at PokeFireVet. If you had $2,000 to spend on Pokemon right now, would you buy cards, booster boxes, UPCs? Booster boxes. Next is from at Trading Card Investments. Thoughts on Shuga versus Marab? Shuga Sean O'Malley is my favorite UFC fighter. I do think he has a super, super good chance. He's been, you know, preparing for wrestling since Sterling. He's known he's had to fight these crazy wrestlers coming up. But yeah, I think he has a super, super good chance. I cannot stand Marab. I hate how he fights. Constant wrestling, just laying on top of people. But yeah, I'm definitely taking Shuga. But seriously, though, I'm so excited for that fight, for the Sphere. I'm actually very, very nervous. Probably the most nervous I've ever been for a UFC fight. But all right, that was today's What If Wednesday. If you guys do have any questions, please drop them down below for a chance to be featured in next week's video. I want you guys to have a great day. And if you want to watch my last Pokemon Market Monday, click this video here. Otherwise, we'll see you next time.